Yeah, I'm at breakfast. It's not really a good time. Can I call you back?
Tina.
Tina, stop worrying. Four AP classes and a school play is not too much. She can handle it. All right, if she falls behind, we'll just get her a tutor. She's a smart kid. She'll be fine. Yes, I will say it nicer than that. Okay. Bye, Tina.
Angie, you cannot smoke pot.
It's not illegal.
Yes, it is. You are 16 years old.
I want to live with Mama T.
You want me to call her right now and tell her what you did today?
Fine, I'll just tell her that you fucked somebody.
I'm pretty sure she already heard.
Looking ahead, is there anything else I need to know?
Meaning? Is there anything else people could use against you?
Okay. Well, I spent a night in jail. With civil disobedience, the charges were dropped.
Okay.
I cheated on my ex-wife.
Does she know you're unfaithful?
Yes, she knows.
Anything else?
I mean, my father never accepted me. Ever. To the day he died, he called my partner, the woman that I love beyond measure, he called her my friend. As if our love was less than. And our love is not less than. But it was painful. You know, it still is.
I just want to feel normal again. Just give me some good news. Tell me how long it took for you to feel normal after Tina.
Well, you're assuming that I feel normal now.
You don't?
No.
Great.
I still miss the kind of love that I had with Tina. It made me feel alive. I never thought she would fall in love with someone else. Everything changed when she left me. I talked to the head of the school and it all set. Yes, done deal. So I'm gonna take the deposit out of my bank account and send it over there. Yeah, you can do it if you want, whatever works for you. Thank you.
Your tea?
Thanks. Yeah, you too. Bye, T. T and I chose the best school for you. Okay, you have to trust that as adults, sometimes we can see the bigger picture.
Angie called me.
Tina.
Well, was Jordy good? Angie said she was nervous.
She makes me nervous.
Well, anyone that likes our daughter is gonna make us nervous.
Mm. Do you think they've had sex?
No. They haven't even kissed yet.
Well, that's one thing done right, I guess.
You were doing a lot right. Do you want to tell me what happened last night?
We were all leaving the play. And then Angie stepped in between us, almost like to protect me. He pushed her down to the ground. He put his hands on our daughter, and he fucking pushed her to the ground. So I pushed him, and I thought, for a second, I don't know what's gonna happen. I don't know what's gonna happen.
That's new. I like it.
Oh, thanks. I got it a couple months ago at Faye Klein.
I miss that place. Oh my God, she is so much like you.
And you too. I mean, me, I hope I haven't just screwed her up.
You're a good mom.
So are you.
I'm just glad that you were able to create so much space for her.
Of course.
That doesn't come natural to you.
What are you saying?
You could never do that for me. But I definitely put your career first. Your feelings first.
I never asked you to do that.
You didn't have to. Everything was on your timeline, on your terms.
I don't think that's fair.
Of course you don't. Because you're never wrong.
Look around. I'm wrong all the fucking time.
Are you still seeing that woman?
I broke up with her yesterday, before any of this even happened. You know, Felicity was there for me when Kit died.
I wish I could have been there.
You could have at least come to the funeral.
I would have made it harder for you. We had just gotten divorced. I had just left. It would have been very confusing if I had shown up.
Such a bullshit excuse. You should have been there. I thought you were my family.
That was a great speech.
Thank you.
You're gonna make a great mayor.
We'll see.
If you need anything, I'm here. I am your family. You know?
I know.
I love you.
I love you.
Come here.
Please don't go.
Please. Dana would have loved this place.
Hearing Angie's first little heartbeat.
Oh my God, me too.
Oh, we were sobbing.
Just bawling.
Oh, and what is it that you said that sounded like?
Like horses stampeding in the mud. Are you available tonight for dinner? Just us?
Sure, yeah. That would be nice. I mean, you know, actually, why don't you come by the house and I'll cook?
Thank you for cooking. It's delicious, as always.
Oh, well, thank you for letting me. I mean, I don't get to do it often enough anymore.
Oh, my God, me neither.
It's really nice having you back here.
It's nice to be here. And getting to see Angie more often is, it just feels really good.
She's so happy.
Well, I started to look for a place so I could be here during the hiatus.
Wow. Well, if you wanna stay here until you find...
Oh, no, Gary asked me to marry her. And I said yes.
Oh.
Yeah, so we're just gonna look for a place nearby, the two of us.
Congratulations. Really, that's incredible.
How do you think that we should tell Angie?
Well,
I was thinking that you and me and Carrie, we could all tell her together.
All three of us. Oh, sure.
I think that would be nice for Angie.
Yeah, Angie's gonna be... She's gonna be thrilled. We should celebrate. We should totally celebrate. I think I might have some champagne. I'm so happy for you.